This video shows how to automate the generation of drawings for manufacturing purpose, for example, in the case of a stayed cable bridge. The tension in every stayed cable is an input given by a strength analysis, and the output could be a set of DXF drawings showing at which angle every cable anchor should be welded on the side of the deck, taking into account the slack in each cable. To automate generation of stayed cable drawings, we'll make a parametric stay cable assembly with its drawing, then we'll create a PLM template from it, and we'll create an action to automate instantiation process. The coordinate system of the parametric model will be reused just after instantiation by the action to reposition each new anchor in a local axis system, so that when you open it alone, it will happen to be designed locally. To automate drawing extraction, a string attribute will be used as a parameter of the PLM template and set with an increment number by the action. A batch will then use this name to find all related drawings in database and extract them. This is the parametric stay cable subassembly with a tension parameter to drive the cable shape, and also the position of anchor. I have attached a drawing to this subassembly to display at which angle the part should be welded on the deck flange. Let's create a template from this. The two parts of the anchor that will only be reinstantiated are left in the unchanged component zone. The inputs are the cable extremity on the tower and the surface on the deck flange. The tension in the cable is a parameter of this template. And we'll also create a string parameter to rename the final subassembly and the attached drawing. It's important to be careful in the naming of inputs and parameters because these names are used in the EKL script. Then rename this template and save it. This is how I store templates in a catalog chapter to easily retrieve all matters. Before starting a script for multi-instantiation of a template, it's always a good practice to test it manually. So I select destination product and inputs, the point representing the cable extremity on the tower, the side surface of the deck, the tension value, and most importantly the drawing title, here to be drawing_6. This part is tricky. An engineering connection locates the newly created subassembly in the local axis system on the deck. Now the anchor axis system is the axis on the deck. And after a global update, it will get its final shape. This mechanism is the same as the one used in component-based design, and this is why in this case the base axis system is not an input of the template. Now let's check the drawing. It has the right title and updates properly. So we can create an action to automate the instantiation process. Action creation in the app called Engineering Role Capture of Template Designer Role. You will find the script in the description of this video. This line in the script is where the engineering connections are created. The script is using two resources described in the resource table, the PLM template and the design table with tension values for each cable. This is the resource table to identify the template and the design table in the database with the logical name used in the script. Let's run this action now. Select the destination product. This is a node under which the items will be created, and then the geometrical set containing the points in the tower and the access system on the deck. I recorded the starting time before running the script. In 2 minutes and 45 seconds, we get all the cable anchors designed in place with their drawing. Let's check one of them. The version 3, item 15, the subassembly and drawing have the good title. And the drawing looks good. But it needs an update, so before extracting all drawings in DXC format, we'll run a batch process to update all drawings. This batch is called Drawing Batch. Use the search to retrieve all drawings. So in our example here, all anchors, version 3, and then press Run. I did this operation already, so I am only showing here the report you would get. And now we can proceed to the drawing extraction using the batch called Data Exchange PLM Batch. Search for all drawings again and press Run. You will finally get this list of DXF files. To use the title to name them, use the system variable in the description of this video, but then be careful to make every drawing name unique. And finally, this is showing all the generated drawings.